Is the opposition invisibilized in the India of today? Is there an opposition? I'm joined by Dr. Prakash Ambedkar of the Vanchit Bahujan Agadi, which is the new force in Maharashtra politics. Dr. Sanjay Raut, or Mr. Sanjay Raut, fellow journalist, editor of Samna, Shiv Sena MP. Many believe he is the real opposition in Maharashtra. The chief minister today said he doesn't read the Samna, but it often makes the headlines. And with us is a former chief minister, Prithviraj Chavan of the Congress, who has taken time off from the fact that he is contesting the elections that have been declared today. Thank you all very much, gentlemen, for joining us. Your mics are next to you. Let me start with you, Mr. Chavan. Is the Congress alive? Congress zinda hai? Tiger zinda hai, lekin Congress zinda hai ki nahi?
Look, Rajdeep, we did badly in 2014 Lok Sabha election and the 2014 Maharashtra Assembly election, primarily because just before the elections, hours before the election, our alliance broke. A 15-year-old alliance between Congress and NCP broke. We were completely taken by surprise. We had to find 125 candidates within 24 hours. They did very badly. And because we split in 2014 assembly election, people did not give us any chance, we did badly. Now, we are a very small shunk opposition in the last assembly for 5 years. NCP had 41 members, we had 42 members in a house of 288. Our presence had been shunk, and therefore we couldn't make the possible impact that we should have done as an opposition party. We admit that. But we raised many issues, and there are certain within party problems about who should lead the party in the state, and I don't want to go to that. But yes, Congress party's performance in over the last 5 years in the assembly and on the streets could have been better.
Prithviraj Chavan, my question to you was direct. Congress zinda hai. Congress is not just a Maharashtra party, it's a national party. Is the Congress alive? There are 192 Lok Sabha seats, sir, where there was a direct contest between the Congress and BJP in the 2019 Lok Sabha. The BJP won 175 of them. Average margin of victory was 23%. I am asking you a larger question.
Well, Rajdeep,
is the Congress in ICU? Is it in a state of rigor mortis? Should we declare the patient?
Well, Rajdeep,
R.I.P.
We all know that Congress party did very badly in 2019 election, as it did in 2014 election.
Yes.
We had leadership crises. We did not perform as an effective opposition and all that. But you see, Congress party is present in every village of every state, maybe in a larger number, smaller number, and we could not make an electoral impact. I admit that. But I don't accept that Congress party is dead. It may not make as much impact in elections, but we have won 3 state elections. If Congress party was dead, how could we win 3 Lok Sabha elections this year? I mean, three assembly elections recently.
Okay, so you're saying the Congress is still alive. Reports of your death are exaggerated.
Well, we did badly in 77 also.
Okay. The Congress has an unusual knack of reminding us of history. But let me turn for a moment to Maharashtra, Dr. Prakash Ambedkar. Because you are now pitching yourself as the opposition here. And what are you doing? You are ending up dividing the anti-BJP Shiv Sena vote. Let's be very clear. Who is your opposition? The part of the problem of the opposition in this country is that it doesn't seem to know who its main rival is. Is the Congress NCP your rival? Or is the Shiv Sena BJP your main rival? Who is your main rival?
Rajdeep, if you allow me to go into history, earlier it was the Congress party till the 90s, which was in the opposition. So in the ruling party, and therefore everybody opposed the Congress party. Today it is the Sena BJP, which is the ruling party, and therefore we are against Sena BJP. Let me tell you another thing. You must learn to realize social realities. All of us are accusing that we are a B team of BJP, but you never criticize. And I'll just close this thing. You never realized that what you were, use the word in Marathi is salgadi, that is a yearly slave. That system is abolished. Why don't you allow the downtrodden of this country to have their own organizations? Are you time and again saying that these downtrodden, who may be from the smaller OBCs, maybe the Muslims, maybe religious people, should hover between either Congress or BJP? Is this what you are suggesting?
No, I am.
And this is what is being said across. After being said across, let me remind you. You just heard in the Senate that EVM is hacked. I was the first person in 2004 to make the allegation that my elections were hacked in 2004. Even I continue today saying that the machines are hacked. Even after being hacked, I have nearly about 1,000 Nagadi has collected 40 lakhs of vote. Let us respect this 40 lakhs voters that even after 24/7, allegations being made not by one channel, but by 24 channels, round the clock, people defied you and they voted for Vanchit Bahujan Aghadi. So let's accept that this is a rising force, this is a force of the oppressed and the neglected class, and we must allow this force to come up, otherwise this will be fodder for rest of the destructive forces.
Sir, let me give you though the arithmetic. 8 to 10 Lok Sabha seats were lost by the
I'll just interrupt you for a minute.
Yes.
You add those words which you're going to say of Congress Party, which were the Muslim votes, into my coffer, then you have the same position that I am winning 6 to 7 seats. Why don't you accept that proposition?
Okay. Let me ask you my question. It is believed that 8 to 10 Lok Sabha seats were lost by the Congress NCP because you put up candidates. The charge against you, therefore, was that you were the B team of the BJP, that Amit Shah sponsored the helicopter by which you travelled across Maharashtra, and therefore, Asauddin Owaisi and you were sponsored by the BJP with one purpose, bring down the Congress NCP vote. How do you respond to that?
I think so. You should realize, because your channel carried the checks that I paid from the Vanchit Bahujan Aghadi and Bharipa Bahujan Mahasangh account to the helicopter aviation company which allotted me that helicopter. That the funds that have come and which I have paid is come from the accounts, from the bank account, from the State Bank of India. Did you verify as to who are the donors in those accounts? The donor is the common man, who donated 5,000, 10,000 into the accounts directly. You don't verify, but you go on making allegations.
Okay, so you're saying...
So question is, right around, let me come to another question which I'm going to ask. If you are charged under, CRP's IPC 420, the law says that the police has to arrest you and produce it before the courts. I'm asking a simple question. How many are charged under this section in the present government from the Congress Party? And why they are not being arrested till today? Why the law is not taking the course? Should I make the allegation that, no, there is a secret understanding between the Congress and the BJP? Should I make this allegation?
Okay, okay.
I think you should allow every party to function in the manner in which it is functioning, except that they will function in that manner. Don't start casting accusation at some forces, because these accusations, let me tell you, is helping me in the sense that those who are donating us and those who are feeling neglect in the society are saying that they are now being mangled, they have been labeled, and they don't have a right to stand on their own legs.
Okay, let me leave it. I take your point. You claim, therefore, that every political party has a right to its existence, and therefore you want to provide an alternative to the Congress and the BJP. Sanjay Raut, what alternative are you providing? Many believe that you are the opposition. Every morning in the Samna, you attack Prime Minister Modi and Devendra Fadnavis. What is going on? Are you in the opposition or in the government? Who
has said that we are... मोदी जी के ऊपर अटैक कर रहे हैं या मुख्यमंत्री के ऊपर अटैक कर रहे हैं? आप मुझे बताइए,
आपके मेरे
आपको ऐसा क्यों लगता है कि हमारा अटैक उनके ऊपर ही है? देखिए, कल प्रधानमंत्री जी नाशिक में आए महा आशीर्वाद यात्रा और
जनादेश यात्रा आपकी यात्रा आशीर्वाद है उनकी जनादेश है।
आशीर्वाद के लिए तो आते हैं, जनादेश यात्रा में आए और क्या स्पीच दिया मोदी जी ने कि राम मंदिर के बारे में बयानबाजी बंद होनी चाहिए, कुछ लोग बयानबाजी करते हैं
जी।
तो हमने मोदी जी के बयान का स्वागत किया है आज, आपने देखा होगा सामना, और बताया है कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी में अगर डिसिप्लिन लानी है तो मोदी जी के बयान को गंभीरता से लेना चाहिए, क्योंकि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के उनके कैबिनेट में ऐसे कुछ लोग हैं जो बार बार जिस प्रकार की बयानबाजी करते राम मंदिर के बारे में, जैसे उत्तर प्रदेश में एक मंत्री है उनके कोई क्या कहा लास्ट वीक कि राम मंदिर का निर्णय जल्दी हमारे पक्ष में आ जाएगा क्योंकि सुप्रीम कोर्ट हमारे है। इस प्रकार की बयानबाजी से मोदी जी को बहुत अड़चन पैदा होती है, तो मोदी जी ने जो ये बात कही है उसका स्वागत किया हमने।
सर आप मेरे पास पूरी लिस्ट है
आप
जो चीजें आपने मोदी जी के बारे में कही है। चौकीदार चोर है जब राहुल गांधी कहता था, आप लोगों ने राहुल गांधी के बयान का समर्थन किया, ये किस तरह का विपक्ष है, ये किस तरह के सहयोगी है, आप सहयोगी के बजाय विपक्ष की तरह भाषा करते हैं, ये किस तरह की भाषा है।
मुझे लगता है ये
मैंने देवेंद्र फडणवीस को पूछा, उन्होंने कहा वो सामना पढ़ते ही नहीं,
उनको सामना पढ़ना पड़ता है लेकिन बता नहीं सकते ओपनली। अगर सामना नहीं पड़ेगा तो राजनीति कैसे करेंगे देश में और महाराष्ट्र में।
उन्होंने कहा ये पब्लिक पोस्चरिंग है, एक भी डिसीजन कैबिनेट का शिवसेना ने विरोध नहीं किया, ये विरोध केवल सामना में होता है।
सामना के संपादक प्रमुख संपादक कौन है आपको मालूम है ना? बाला साहब ठाकरे थे, उद्धव ठाकरे है, उनके साथ मैं हूं। जब उद्धव ठाकरे ओपनली डिनाई करेंगे कि सामना से मेरा कोई संबंध नहीं है तब ये बात तो कह सकते हैं।
तो सामना में जो भी आता है वो दैट इज द वॉइस ऑफ द शिवसेना,
डेफिनेटली पार्टी लाइन है।
यानी चौकीदार चोर है पे जब आपने एडिटोरियल लिखा था वो पार्टी लाइन थी?
नहीं नहीं, देखिए चौकीदार चोर के बारे में सामना में हमने खबरें छापी है, एडिट नहीं लिखा है। जब हम एडिट लिखते हम लिखते हैं तो समझ लीजिए पार्टी लाइन है। आप भी अखबार चलाते हैं आपको मालूम है।
संजय राउत आप बड़े डिफेंसिव हो रहे हैं आज, पर ठीक है।
नहीं, मैं डिफेंसिव नहीं हूं, मैं मेरी बात,
चुनाव आ गए हैं,
चुनाव की बात तो हम कभी ज्यादा गंभीरता से लेते भी नहीं। चुनाव आते हैं चुनाव जाते हैं, पार्टी है संगठन है वो हमारे लिए बहुत मजबूत है, हार जिससे क्या होता है।
बट पृथ्वीराज चव्हाण व्हाट इज ट्रू, यू नो समवन यूज दिस वर्ड द शिवसेना इज द मैनेज्ड ऑपोजिशन बिकॉज दे आर पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट एंड द कांग्रेस इज द डिसअपीयर्ड ऑपोजिशन हैज डिसअपीयर्ड। I mean, can you imagine a state where the leader of the opposition for 5 years goes and joins the government just before the election and becomes a minister? What does this say about your party, sir?
Well, two things. About Shiv Sena, I can say one thing, that Shiv Sena has never opposed any decision of the government in the cabinet. So, okay, posturing or editorials and all that is one thing. But Shiv Sena is a member of the Devendra Fadnavis cabinet. Ministers are there in the cabinet. The ministers are there in the Modi government also. So we consider this part of the government. They cannot run away from bad decisions of Devendra Fadnavis government by saying, no, no, we attacked Devendra Fadnavis in Samala. Now, our party, yes, you mentioned the leader of opposition. It was a tragic error to appoint the person who was appointed and to continue him for 5 years. And Congress party has paid a huge price because we could not expose the corruption of the government, the chief minister, which could be done with the leader of opposition in assembly, outside and all that. And I think the whole thing was leader of opposition appeared to have been managed. It is Congress party's problem.
You're saying the leader of the opposition was managed.
As
you are
appears,
saying the leader of the opposition was managed for 5 years.
Yes.
For 5 years he was managed, and now when elections are declared,
managed
you're telling.
Managed or allowed to be managed.
Sorry?
Managed or allowed to be managed.
You could say that. It is tragic that happened. We are a very small party in the assembly, and we failed to play a very effective role of an opposition, which could be done from the floor of the house. But outside, we had very positive Jan Sangharsh Yatras together with NCP. Which forced the government to sanction the loan waiver scheme in Maharashtra. We exposed corruption on the floor of the house. Chief Minister had to order many inquiries, but we can't conclude the inquiries. In one case, the minister was removed. So, but still the charges did not stick because we could have gone about it in every day.
But look at the way Mr. Chavan, leader after leader of the Congress and NCP is joining the BJP Sena. What does that say? If senior leaders of your party, legislators are leaving you and joining the BJP or Sena, the impression that we get is that you are a sinking ship. Are you a sinking ship at the moment? Would you concede that this is therefore the biggest crisis that the Congress has faced in the history of the party?
Well, the Congress has faced a crisis in 2014 in Lok Sabha, in Assembly 19. Yes, we admit that. A lot of leaders have left from both parties, NCP and Congress. Now, it is part of a strategy of the Bharatiya Janata Party, particularly Amit Shah, who started out saying that he wants to see an India which is Congress mukt, that is opposition mukt. Later on, they changed the phraseology because RSS said, don't use those words. But what has happened? Chief Minister says, our philosophy sam, dam, dandabhed. Whatever means to finish the opposition. Now, people have been coerced, people have been blackmailed, inducements have been offered, positions have been given. Take, for example, the issue of the leader of opposition. Leader of opposition resigns his assembly seat in assembly, becomes a minister within a week, violates the constitution. The constitution which is amended by Atal Bihari Vajpayee in 2003, the 91st constitution amendment, specially ruled out the individual defection of a member. We have a PIL pending in the courts. The high courts are not ruled in our favor. It's pending now in the next level of court. We have challenged the induction of ministers who just resign and become ministers. It is nothing but political corruption by the chief minister.
You know, when I hear this from the Congress party, the fact is in the 1980s, you did it. Today, when I asked this question to the chief minister, he said Sharad Pawar used to break parties. We are doing what he used to do.
But it is supposed to be a party with a difference. So it is no party with a difference. It is copying Congress party. We did something wrong, paid a price for it. Now, BJP will certainly pay a price of it. Leaders have left. The question this election will decide is whether voters and the followers and the general public also have left with those leaders.
Prakash Ambedkar, what is your sense? You are a third player in this. Why do you think the Congress has become such a weak party and the BJP is such a dominant party? Why do you think that's happened?
See, let's... What's the difference between Congress and BJP, if you ask me today? I don't see any difference.
You don't see any difference?
I don't see any difference. You come to religion, BJP is a hard Hindutvadi. Congress is a soft Hindutvadi. Earlier, Congress would follow the Gandhian economy. In the 90s, they gave away the Gandhian economy and they came back to capitalist economy or the open economy. Now you come back again to the issue of opposition parties. Congress destroyed the opposition during its period. BJP is doing the same thing at the present stage. Let me remind what my grandfather wrote when the states were being formed. He said, thy cursed India, thy shall never be united. It's a time to ponder whether that frame is going to be true.
Are you saying if your grandfather, the architect of the constitution was still alive, he would mourn the demise of the constitution? Do you believe that the constitution has been murdered?
Let me complete what I have to say. Is there an opposition party today? I would say no. Congress is withering away. We have regional sartaps. Regional parties cannot become a national parties overnight. To build a party takes a long period of time. Let's hope Modi continues for a longer time in the interest of the nation, even though I oppose him tooth and nail. If I may say, any person who will go down in the history as being one of the worst prime minister is the present prime minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. You are destroying the fabric of the nation. You are destroying the culture of the nation. You are destroying the homogeneity of this nation. To build all these things, it takes a long time. The freedom movement built the homogeneity, built the feeling of oneness within ourselves. that generation is over, today's generation has taken over, where religion has become more important, and the next factor which is becoming more important is the caste.
No, you are so, no, no, one minute.
So
one
I
minute.
Must, I'm let me
no,
let
no,
me,
one minute.
Let
you
me
are,
complete,
no, no, one
let
minute.
Me complete,
if
let
you
me
feel
complete.
If you feel so strongly about all these issues, why don't you tie up with Prithviraj Chavan?
Question
why doesn't the Congress join? Why don't you
me,
join
let
hands?
Me let me now put across what I asked for the last part. We were never interested in Parliament. He's a witness to it. What did I ask for Vanchit Bahujan Aghadi? I said share seats that you are going to lose.
Share the seats you are going to lose.
Lose. You are sure if you are going to lose this seat, then share with us. This was my demand with the Congress party. I was not asking for a winning seat.
What did they tell you?
They said we are not going to share a single seat. And they didn't share a single seat. And therefore we had to fight on our own.
That's not true.
That I mean, is absolutely true. Don't deny
we
it
were,
now. It's
we were ready
press.
To... We
it
were ready
everywhere.
To offer
so don't deny
6 to 8
you
seats.
You are a party of
Mr.
Idiots.
Ambedkar were one from Akola.
You are a party who has not stepped down in saying that you are going to accept the downtrodden. You still believe in the hierarchy system. And that hierarchy system is today eating the Congress party.
You know, you're using this word downtrodden. The real word is caste. You are accused of playing caste politics.
The question
just
is,
as you accuse the BJP of playing Hindutva politics, they are accusing you of trying to create a 21st century brand caste politics for a new Maharashtra.
What I'm trying to do is unite all the caste and all the communities that were denied power ages together and even in the last 70 years of parliamentary democracy. Can you give me one candidate in Maharashtra from the Kumbhar community, from the Lohar community, from the Alutedar, Balutedar, who are given parliamentary seat and assembly seat, you can be one. There was a caste politics. Why do you deny that?
Okay.
Out of 48 constituencies, every constituency was from one caste. Why do you deny that? Only the reserve seats, either for the scheduled caste or for the tribal, leaving apart, they were all one caste.
Okay, let me...
That's what the politics played about by Congress and by BJP also.
Okay, so you're trying to socially re-engineer
what politics. What we are trying to do is democratize social, democratize socially and socialize democracy. Both we are trying to do in this country.
Okay, that's an interesting way of putting it. But Sanjay Raut, aap kya kar rahe hain? Inka koi to agenda, aapka agenda kya hai? Aapka agenda hai ki BJP ko sarkar mein hokar blackmail kare? ताकि आपको ज्यादा से ज्यादा कुछ ना कुछ सहूलतें मिले
आप मुझे
शिवसेना का एजेंडा क्या है बाला साहब ठाकरे की पार्टी कहां तक आ गई है
बाला साहब ठाकरे की पार्टी जहां थी वहां ही है एक तो
आप तो छोटे भाई बन गए एक मिनट
ये छोटे
देवेंद्र
फडणवीस
ने साफ कहा हमें कि हमने कोई 50-50 डील में ऐसा नहीं है कि आपको आधे सीट देने वाले हैं
50-50 डील की बात आपने भी सुनी है ऑन कैमरा अमित शाह जी जब मातोश्री में आए थे लोकसभा चुनाव से पहले फिर एक बार गठबंधन में आने के लिए तब आपने वरली के होटल ब्लू सी में पूरा देश का मीडिया सामने था देवेंद्र जी थे उद्धव ठाकरे साहब थे अमित शाह जी थे तब ये तय हुआ था कैमरे के सामने सबने सुना है कि सीट शेयरिंग 50-50 एंड पावर शेयरिंग 50-50
नहीं अमित शाह के 50-50 और आपके 50-50 में फर्क है
नहीं हमारा गंठा
आपको अमित शाह में विश्वास है
देखिए हम व्यापारी
आपको लगता
नहीं
है अमित शाह आपको 50% सीट देंगे
बात अमित शाह जी की नहीं है मुझे लगता है शिवसेना में उतनी ताकत जरूर है जो चाहिए वो निकालने की
हु इज द नंबर वन पार्टी शिवसेना या बीजेपी
देखिए अब अलायंस और गठबंधन में नंबर वन नंबर टू की बात हम नहीं करेंगे अब अलायंस में गठबंधन है गठबंधन में दोनों पार्टी बराबर चलती
नहीं पर अगर
एक दो सीट किसी
अगर अमित शाह कहे कि हम 170 सीट लड़ेंगे आपको 120-118 सीट आप तैयार होंगे
देखिए अमित शाह जी जब ये कहेंगे तब हमारी हम बात रखेंगे उनके सामने या आपके सामने पहले कहने तो दीजिए हम बार बार बोल रहे हैं ना पहले कहने दीजिए
आप यहाँ बहुत कुछ कहते हैं अमित शाह के सामने आप डरते हैं कि
आप नहीं देखिए बात डरने की क्या है ये आपकी बात है अमित शाह या मोदी जी हम अपने अंतरात्मा को डरते हैं
नहीं आप उनसे डरते हैं
क्यों डरने की बात बताए ना क्यों डरना चाहिए हमको अब शिवसेना जो महाराष्ट्र में जो राजनीति है ना बेडर और किसी से न डरने की वो शिवसेना ने शुरू किया
वो तो बाला साहब ठाकरे के जमाने में
ठाकरे ही
ठाकरे की रहे
शिवसेना बाला साहब ठाकरे की है, जो आपने कहा ना टाइगर जिंदा है, टाइगर जिंदा है, आपको पता चलेगा टाइगर कितना जिंदा है, टाइगर कितना उछलता है।
चलिए ठीक है, पृथ्वीराज चव्हाण जी, लेट मी आस्क यू इन कंक्लूजन, बिकॉज यू नो द रियल सीरियस क्वेश्चन इज दैट आर वी नाउ बिकमिंग अ सिंगल पार्टी टू पर्सन डेमोक्रेसी। इन दिल्ली इट इज अमित शाह एंड नरेंद्र मोदी एंड द बीजेपी, इन मुंबई देयर इज अ बिलीफ दैट वी आर नाउ बीजेपी एंड दैट व्हाट आई कॉल द टीडो फैक्टर, there is Devendra only. Are you worried as a congressman who's lived in this party that we are actually entering an age where there are no multiple parties anymore? You're not giving the voters a choice. How is the Congress party going to change this?
Well, I think you're absolutely right. At one time we thought that BJP, if it gets absolute majority in parliament, will change the constitution. Atal Bihari Vajpayee set up a national commission to review the working of the constitution. It didn't work. We always thought that the constitution will be amended, but now what they have done is they are finishing the opposition party. So effectively, BJP wants to move towards a one-party rule. A one-party democracy is one-party dictatorship. And that is going to be our appeal to the electorate of Maharashtra. That look what BJP has done. Look,
that will be your issue in Maharashtra.
That will be our issue number one, along with the other issues like unemployment, the collapse of economy, and other issues. Now all these band-aid solutions with the finance minister in Delhi bringing is not going to help the economy at all. So unemployment, collapse of economy, and future of democracy. These are going to be our three main lines, and I'm sure people of Maharashtra will
I just have a minute to go on the program. You've said that you are going to go to the voters of Maharashtra saying, vote for us, otherwise there will be dictatorship in Maharashtra. On what grounds will you vote? 30 seconds. Why should people vote for the Vanchit Bahujan Agadi?
See, we are talking about an alternative system in this country as far as program goes. You have Maharashtra, which is one side is wet and the other side is dry. Why can't we plan out transferring the wet water from the dry to the dry zone, which is very possible now? What we are talking of an alternative economic system where the agro industry becomes a major player in this economy, and that becomes the revival of the economy. Second is what we are saying is that education should be responsibility of the state. Half of the students are left out, half of the students get education at the present stage. There are many issues which we are raising up which concern the settlement. Let's take the case of nomadic tribes in this country. Nobody's worried about the nomadic tribes, who's 12% of the population in this country.
So you're
they were part of
you're calling for a more equal Maharashtra.
Equal
share of resources. Sanjay right. Raut, aap kis tarah ka Maharashtra chahte hain? Ye Shiv Sena ka aakhir mein bataiye. Hamesha jab Bala Sahib hua karte the, aap kehte the bhagwa jhanda lehrega mantralay par. Ab sir, maan lijiye नरेंद्र मोदी का जमाना, ये सवाल मेरे दोस्त साहिल जोशी ने आज पूछा था आदित्य ठाकरे से, वो बच गए उस सवाल से, मैं आपको पूछूंगा, असली हिंदू हृदय सम्राट कौन है, नरेंद्र मोदी या बाला साहेब ठाकरे?
देखिए, असली हिंदू हृदय सम्राट सबसे पहले वीर सावरकर ही थे, उसके बाद बाला साहेब ठाकरे, ये पूरी दुनिया मान चुकी है।
और मोदी?
देखो, मोदी तो हिंदुत्व के सबसे बड़े नेता है, हिंदू हृदय सम्राट कभी बदलते नहीं। महाराष्ट्र की अगर बात कहे तो सबसे दो हिंदू हृदय सम्राट जो महाराष्ट्र ने दिए हैं, आपको पता होगा जब कल्याण सिंह के जमाने में लोग कल्याण सिंह जी को हिंदू हृदय सम्राट कहते थे।
आप वोट किसके नाम पर मांगेंगे, बाला साहेब ठाकरे, उद्धव ठाकरे, आदित्य ठाकरे के नाम, या नरेंद्र मोदी और अमित शाह के नाम? आप किसके नाम पर मांगेंगे वोट?
महाराष्ट्र की यह परंपरा नहीं है, बाला साहेब ठाकरे बहुत बड़े नेता रहे, कभी एक जमाने में कांग्रेस यशवंतराव चव्हाण जी के नाम पर वोट मांगते थे, कभी एनसीपी
आज की तारीख में किसके नाम पर
नरेंद्र मोदी? नरेंद्र मोदी जी देश के नेता है, हिंदुस्तान के प्रधानमंत्री है, उद्धव ठाकरे शिवसेना के प्रमुख है, दोनों के नाम पर वोट मांगेंगे, उसमें क्या है? अगर गठबंधन है तो दोनों के नाम पर मांगेंगे, हमको कोई तकलीफ नहीं है।
चलिए, वेरी गुड, वी विल लीव इट एट दैट। लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, द ऑपोजिशन क्लियरली हैज इट्स ओन चैलेंजेस इन दिस रन अप टू द इलेक्शंस इन महाराष्ट्र। थैंक यू ऑल वेरी मच, पृथ्वीराज चव्हाण, संजय राउत एंड Prakash Ambedkar. Thank you very much for joining us here on the India Today Conclave. Give them a very big hand. Ladies and gentlemen, opposition zinda hai is what we are being told.